In this video, we are going to study about commensalism. It is the interaction or the relationship in which two organisms, living individuals of different species, are interacting, in which one is benefited while the other is neither harmed or nor benefited. For example, in case of cattle ergate, in cattle ergate and grazing cattle association, as the cattle moves out or as the cattle grazes, the insect sticks to its body and the ergate fish that ergate bird, that is cattle ergate, fetches on the body of the cattle and fetches out all the insects that are present on its body. Another example is that of sea anemone and clownfish interaction. In this interaction, fish gets protection from the predators and it attaches to the tentacles of the sea anemone so that they cannot be recognized by the predators and get the protection. Another is the example of interaction between pilot fish and shark. In this, the pilot fish always accompanies the shark without getting attached to the shark. And the pilot fish eats the falling off food when the shark is eating its prey. Now the last population interaction is mutualism. This is the interaction between two organisms of different species where both the partners are benefited and none of them are capable to live separately. For example, in case of lichens, this is a composite entity where there is two types of partners. One is algal partner is called phycobiont, and another partner is the fungal biont. This is called mycobiont. In this association, being autotrophic in nature, algal is capable of producing or preparing food using photosynthesis as a mode of nutrition, and it prepares its food for itself and for its fungal partner, and in return this fungal partner provides fixation, water, minerals and shelter to the algae. And algae manufactures food for itself and for the fungus. This interaction or relationship allows the lichens to live or grow in highly hostile environment like barren rocks. These are also known as the pollution indicators, as they are not grown in the places where there is a pollution or the polluted areas. Another example is rhizobium, interaction between rhizobium bacteria and legumes or the leguminous plants. In this case, nitrogen bacteria is present in the root nodules of leguminous plants. This bacteria is going to fix atmospheric nitrogen for the legumes, and in turn legumes makes food using atmospheric nitrogen and provides it to the bacteria and also gives shelter to the bacteria. Another example is the interaction between the fig trees and species of wasp. In this association, there is a pollinator species of wasp by which these fig trees are pollinated. And these wasps use the fruit of fig trees for laying eggs and for nourishing their larvae. Thus, this wasp pollinates the fig inflorescence while searching for suitable laying sites. In turn, for the favor of pollination, these fig trees offers wasp some of the developing seeds as a food for developing wasp larvae. Thank you. That's all for the population interaction videos.